Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Lisa, also known as La Dolce Lisa, and today's video is definitely going to be different from any other video that I've ever done before, because this is going to sort of be like a story time video mixed in with like a warning. I guess it's kind of like a video where I'm sharing my story on how this horrible thing happened to me, and hopefully you guys can take this as a lesson in order to prevent this from ever happening to you. Basically, you've probably already seen the thumbnail, so as you can imagine, something horrible happened to me during the summertime, and it involved a lime. Literally the citrus fruit. This sort of happened to me as a mysterious situation where I didn't know what was going on with my skin, and I had a mysterious rash out of nowhere. And eventually I got answers, and now I can share my story with you. This happened 2 years ago, so I'm fine now. So let's get into it without chatting too much in the beginning. I'm trying not to ruin things for you, but I'm sort of realizing that clearly my thumbnail gave things away. But basically what happened to me was, one summer we decided to go to the beach. So I kind of just wanted to get a pizza at the beach, which I should have just totally done. But my dad's idea was for us to make like picnic style and bring it with us to the beach, which was fine. That's a cute idea. So I decided to make a pasta salad, and I wanted to give it like Tex-Mex flair, you can say. So I put some lime juice in it. So I was putting like corn and beans and cheese, and then I thought, oh, limes would be nice. And I remember even going to the grocery store and I almost didn't find the limes. And I'm like, oh, I found it last minute. Hooray. So I made this pasta salad the day before because we were going to be leaving super early for the beach the next day. So when I was making the pasta salad, I remember I zested the lime and then I squeezed out all the juice and I made it into this pasta salad. And without thinking clearly, I went outside while I was making the pasta salad and I just like got a little bit of sun. I was tanning a bit. I had my dog Summer with me at the time, so she'd love to sit in my lap when I was outside. So I just went outside for like maybe 30 minutes or so, on and off. Maybe I was outside for like a total of an hour that day. I remember it was really hot. You can see Luna behind me. She's sort of making a mess. This is little Looney here. So I got some sun that day while I made this lime pasta salad. That's important to think about. So the next day I'm going to the beach. I had a beautiful day. We were in the sun all day long. And then on the way home with my ex at the time, I noticed that I had a rash on my hand. So I was looking at my hand and I was like, what do you think this is about? And then we just kind of had the idea that it was probably just a little bit of a sun rash. Maybe I got too much sun that day, not to worry about it. It was like very, very, very light pink. I don't have any photos of that to insert, but you'll see the really bad stuff. So it was fine. I wasn't honestly worried about it. I just thought it was weird because like I never get any rashes. So I didn't think anything of it. I showered that day. I went to bed. I woke up the next day and my hand looked horrible. At this stage, the rash had spread and it was very red. And I remember a couple days before, my sister was letting me play around with some of her lipsticks that she was going to like maybe toss or something. And I remember swatching some things on my hand. So I was thinking, oh my God, I hope those lipsticks weren't old or anything. And maybe they gave me some kind of reaction. So I was a mess. I was so worried about this. I decided to give it some time and have it go down before I went to go to the doctor or to see a walk-in. Now, just so happens that my family doctor was out of town for the summer, pretty much. She was off for like a month, so I couldn't see her. But I have a walk-in in this condo that I live in. I have a walk-in and I have another family doctor. It's not my doctor, but there are basically two doctors that I could have gone to see. So I went to the walk-in at the time, and the walk-in saw the rash, and they didn't really know what was going on, but they prescribed me this topical cream. It was almost like a cortisone cream for burns or for rashes or what have you. And they said that hopefully this should help, if not, you know, come back. So I was worried because I had a trip planned that summer. I was going on a trip to Italy in a month from that point. And I just really wanted to get to the bottom of this. I remember even thinking, I'm like, if I'm not going on a trip, I don't care so much about this rash. I'm just so worried that it's going to be affecting my trip, or that I'm using a product, maybe like a new skincare product or a new makeup product, or I was worried that I was using something that I would have to eliminate, or this was causing me a rash. When you get a mysterious rash out of the blue and you literally have no idea what caused it, you're in your mind, you're thinking it could be anything. So it was just so much stress and so much worry on me. So I remember I was going to go back to the walk-in clinic because the rash didn't go away. It was actually getting worse. And I was so worried that I was doing something to aggravate it even more. I didn't know what to do. So I decided to go back to the walk-in, but they were closed that Saturday. And then my mom told me, go downstairs to the family doctor. My mom said, I've been there once to him. He's a really great doctor. He'll help you out a lot because clearly if the walk-ins close, you can also walk in at the family doctor as well. They accepted some walk-in patients, which was fine. And I saw this doctor, and he seemed like a very intelligent man, but he still couldn't figure out what this was. And I remember him even looking at my rash, and he even showed me, and he said, "It looks like your skin is burned." And then he said, "The most I could do is prescribe you like an even stronger cream than the one you're already using." And then he said, "But you know what? On second thought, I don't think I would prescribe you anything because the one that you're using is pretty strong. So it should be okay. Keep using it. It will hopefully get better soon. If it doesn't, come see me." I even called the dermatologist's office and they weren't accepting patients for like a month. So I would have to wait a month, and that didn't work out because I was going on a trip. So I was so stressed, and I was like, if I can't even see a skin doctor, what am I going to do? So I was kind of like stressed out that I had no answers, but I thought, fine, you know, I'll give this some time. Maybe it just does need to go down. Hopefully it's not anything that I'm using specifically that's causing this. So maybe it will go down on its own. Nope. So I decided to go back to this family doctor, and I kind of really wish that I didn't. I sat with him, and he actually, for once, like, was just seemed really sympathetic towards me, and he was talking to me like I was a person, and he's like, "Listen, Lisa, I'm so sorry, like, I don't know exactly what it is. It's my guess that it has to do with this and this," and he wasn't completely wrong by any means. He just didn't know exactly what caused it. He said, "It looks like some kind of burn, that I was maybe using some kind of chemical or something that reacted with the sun and it burnt my skin. So he told me to stay out of the sun. And he said, all you can do is just keep an eye on it and like just try not to use anything that your skin is unfamiliar with." So I was really confused, and he sat down with me and he talked to me and he said, "Listen, don't worry. I know you're stressed out. You're a beautiful girl, and this is clearly causing you a lot of aggravation, and I feel so sorry for you, but it will get resolved. Are you okay?" And when people talk to me like that, I just started crying in front of this guy, this doctor that I had no idea who he was. I literally burst into tears, and I was so embarrassed. I left his office crying. I mean, he was really nice. He was trying to console me. Him being so nice to me just made me feel worse for some reason. I don't know. So I just started crying. So I remember leaving his office, and I'm like, great, I can never see this family doctor again because I cried and I completely embarrassed myself. I'm just a really emotional person, and like my emotions were at an all-time high. So that being said, thankfully my sister's boyfriend Attic, his mother Lucy is a nurse, and she told me about this amazing thing that I had no idea about. She said, "Listen, there is a 24-hour dermatologist clinic. Just get a referral from anybody, your family doctor, a walk-in doctor, anybody. Get a referral for a dermatologist, bring it with you, and you can see this dermatologist's office within 24 hours. The only thing is you'll have to get there super early in the morning, and you'll have to wait at least 3 hours to be seen," which was completely fine. So if you're familiar with the Toronto area, this was a dermatologist clinic in the Distillery District area. I had my little referral with me. I went that day. I went with my sister. She came to give me moral support in case I cried again at a doctor's office. So I went there, and I just had heard good things about this dermatologist clinic, and I said, if anyone should know what's going on with my skin, it's definitely a dermatologist. Hopefully this doctor will give me some answers, or he'll give me a better idea of what's going on. So finally, after the long wait, I sat down with the doctor and I explained the situation. I just said I got a rash out of the blue. I tried to explain as much as I could. And I said, you know, the doctors don't exactly know what's going on with me, so I just really wish I knew what it was. At least that way I don't have to panic anymore or worry that I'm doing something to cause my skin to get worse. So he sat down with me, and I guess he was just like a very witty, like almost sarcastic doctor. So he's sitting down with me, and he's like, yep, he's like, you're right. It must be really difficult for these doctors to diagnose it. It seems really, really a complicated thing. And I was like, oh my God, don't tell me he's not gonna give me answers. And he's like, okay, here's what it is. And he wrote down on the sheet of paper, you know, the sheet that you sit on at the doctor's office, he wrote down phytophotodermatitis. And he's like, do you know what that means? I'm like, does it have to do with like the sun being burnt? He's like, yep, limes. And as soon as he said limes, a light bulb went off in my head, a light bulb went off in my sister Jules' head. So we looked at each other and we're like, limes? Limes! Oh my God. That day, when we went to the beach, I made a freaking pasta salad with limes in it, and I happened to go in the sun that day, and I happened to go in the sun the next day, so I got a lot of sun exposure, and I still had some clearly lime oils from the zest and the juice on my skin, and I got a rash a little bit over here, just like tiny little splotches of a rash. It wasn't so bad at my neck, but the worst was on my hand, and he said it was from limes. When he said that, I was like so relieved because I was just so happy to know what it actually was, and he told me not to worry, and he said that it will go down on its own, but it could take anywhere from a month to like 3 months, even 6 months if you're really unlucky, but he said it's actually very common. So I'm going to read you guys about it. If you search lime burns on skin, you will find out exactly what this is. So it says, A stray splash of lime juice can turn fun in the sun into a second degree burn. It's also called Lyme disease or margarita dermatitis, which he told me because he said that there's like these drinks that people drink or these shots that they take with limes and they'll drink it. And sometimes people come in with a rash down their mouth like this. And it's literally from the lime juice staining your skin. And if the sun is specifically strong that day, it will burn your skin. It says,
yes, my uni, okay.
It says, effects of the reaction begin within minutes with a rash forming within 24 hours. So within minutes, your skin will get burned from having lime juice on your skin. Skin once covered in lime juice becomes red and sometimes blisters. That doctor, he was such a good looking man and he just like made me so happy that day. I wanted to literally hug and kiss him. I just was happy to know what it was and happy to know that, don't worry, this will eventually go away. Guys, I really had no idea what this was. It caused me so much aggravation and heartache. And I just want this to be a warning to you guys now that summer is right around the corner. I mean, I even have some really good recipes that involve limes, like my delicious key lime pie that I'm thinking of maybe filming one day. And I would never want to be responsible in having you guys make something like that. Going in the sun that day and ruining your summer, getting second degree burns on your skin from limes. Guys, it's been 2 years and I feel like I could even see like just a tiny little dot left over from what was my horrible skin condition at the time. Right, Luna? It was horrible. I still went to Italy that year. I had a little bit of like the leftover rash on my skin, but it was much lighter than what you saw in the pictures. I took pictures of it when it was at its worst, so it looked really horrible. Don't squeeze the lime in your beer. It's not worth it. I seriously avoid limes at any cost because that happened to me. It's not just an urban legend, guys. It is real. So please be very, very careful of your skin in the sun, and especially when using citrus fruits like limes. Be very, very careful. Take my advice, heed my warnings, don't go in the sun with limes. You will thank me for it. Like I said, I hope that everyone can have a safe and fun summer without having something like that happen to you. In the grand scheme of things, getting a rash on your hand is not the worst thing that can happen to you, but it's definitely not something you want to happen to you, especially right before you're going on a trip. Without sounding dramatic, guys, learn from my mistakes and never use limes in the sun. Limes and sun, they don't mix. So thank you guys so much for listening to me and thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos in the future. Until then, guys, have a happy and safe summer. Don't use limes and I'll see you in my next video. Bye, guys. My symptoms, and I feel like,
yes, what is it?
She wants me to still better. And I remember even Googling my symptoms.
What is it?
Oh, she wanna give me a kiss because she knows I'm stressed telling this story. So, like I was saying, I don't know what you want.
What do you want from me, my angel?
Luna's being so sweet right now. I don't know why.
You're being such a cutie.